Hey everyone, I am Mr. Helper. In today's video, I am going to show you how to run C programs in command prompt. Or you can also say how to run C program in CMD. Before I start explaining the steps, let me tell you this. This video might be a long one. So please keep patience. I will going to explain each and everything. That's why this video might be a long one. And one more thing, this video is divided into multiple parts. Like part 1 will be the downloading part. Part 2 will be the installing part, part 3 will be configuration part, and last part will be the bonus part that I will talk at the bonus part. Okay, so as usual, you have to go to the description of this video. Under downloading section, you will going to find my website link. Link will be something like this: www.iammrhelper.com/windows/programs/coding. Link will be something like that. I believe you got it. Simply click on it. And after clicking on it, you will going to land on this page. Now scroll down a little bit, and right over here under downloading section, there is two links. I believe some of you know what is Notepad++. This is optional. You can download it or you can leave it. It's up to you. But this is important. Okay, I am providing you MinGW download links. Okay, and these two are the official link. As you can see from the bottom left corner of the screen, it is saying mingw.org and this is notepad++.org. So there is no way I am scamming you. Okay, first of all, click on this link, and after clicking on it, you will going to land on this page. Now click on downloads. Since we are a Windows user, we will going to click on this link, I mean this button. Now it asking me, where do you want to download this MinGW setup file? I will download it in my desktop. So file downloaded successfully. Guys, this is optional. You didn't need it. If you want, you can download it. You can skip this part, okay? Since I am a Windows 10 user, 64-bit, so I am going to download this 64-bit file. Now downloading part completed, go to the desktop. And guys, if you having any doubt, then please scan this through your antivirus. Okay, I believe there is no virus. So downloading part completed. Now what we have to do is double click on this file, click on install, and please guys, don't change anything from here. Let it be as default setting. Okay, click on continue. Okay, it looks like I have already installed this program in my computer. That's why it's showing me this error. Don't worry, you won't going to get this problem. Okay, if you are getting, then simply click on reinstall. Click on continue. After that, make sure you have clicked on basic setup, not in all packages. Okay, now what you have to do is check this one, click on mark for installation, and click on installation, and click on apply, apply changes. Guys, this required internet connection, so please check your internet connection. Click on apply. Since I have quite fast internet connection, so it doesn't let me show you that how long it take me to download this file, but it will definitely going to take you around 1 to 2 minutes. Okay, once you see these things, all changes was applied successfully, you can close it. Click on close. Now click on this one, close. Now installation part completed, and this is optional. By the way guys, if you don't know what is Notepad++, it is a advanced text editor like Notepad. Okay, Windows Notepad. But this is an advanced one. Okay, you can do multiple things. You can install it anywhere. Okay, so installation part completed. Now what we have to do is, it's time to configure. Open this PC. Right click on this PC, click on properties, click on advanced system settings, environment variables. Under system variables, try to find path, click on edit. Now get back to this PC, open C drive, MinGW bin, cut this path and get back to the settings right over here. Click on new, click on paste, right click and paste, click on OK, OK and OK. Now you can close this one. Now go to C drive, Windows, System32, scroll down and try to find CMD. Here it is. Right click. Click on send to desktop. Okay. Now close it. Now we have done the configuration part. Now it's for the bonus part. So in bonus part I will going to show you that you don't have to open CMD and go to the location, change directory again and again. I will going to show you the shortcut way. Okay. I am assuming that you want to create your C program at your desktop. Okay. So let's create a folder and name it as demo. Okay. Open it. Now move this CMD under here. Cut this path. Right click, properties, and paste it over here. And click on apply. Click on OK. Now click on view. Check this one, file name extensions. Okay. This will definitely gonna help you to do programming. Now first of all, let me show you how you can code in CMD. Okay. Now it's time to write some codes. So I have written a very basic program which will gonna print thank you for watching my video. Visit www.iammrhelper.com for more videos like this. Okay, click on file, click on save. Since our project folder is right over here at my desktop, so I will go to the desktop, demo, and save as type. Click on it and click on all files. Now name the file. I am going to name it as new.c. .c is very important. Please type .c also. Click on save. And right over here is the file. Okay, our C file. Now double click on this CMD. And as you can see, CMD opened under this location. You don't have to change the directory. This is the bonus part that I was talking about. Okay. Type gcc dash, I mean space, name of the file, name of the C file, which is in our case new.c, space minus o space exe file. In our case we want output as new.exe, press enter, and as you can see new file has been created, which is .exe, new.exe. double click. Okay, I have done some mistake I think over here. Okay, that's why it's not changing the line. Okay, no problem, I will update it. Okay, that's why I think. Okay, let's do it again. Let's do the same thing again. And let me show you that it is updating. Okay. And as you can see, it is now updated. Okay. And you can do the same thing with Notepad++ also. Click on file, click on save, click on desktop, demo. I will gonna name it as demo. Okay, demo.c. Make sure you are changing things from here. Save as type to all files, okay, all types. In Notepad++ it is all types. Click on save and demo. Now once again type gcc demo.c dash o name of the file, exe file that you need. In my case this time I am going to name it as helper.exe. okay, you can name anything you want to, but make sure you are not adding spaces like this. Okay, this will be the error or you might get some problems. Okay, so please avoid this. Okay, and don't create any file in spaces also in C. Okay, I believe you got the point. Sometimes I think you are not getting the point, that's why I always explain in detail, and then I realize that I have explained a lot that was not required. And as you can see it is running. Okay, and there's one more thing I want to share. Although I'm not going to provide this thing, this info.txt in description, if I can I will, otherwise please don't think that I will gonna provide it. Okay, so gcc means gnu compiler collection, file name .c means c program source file, which is .c means c program source file, dash o means output file. As you notice, this is a compiler, we are calling compiler. This is our file, c file. This is output format that we need, and naming it as, okay, so I believe you got the point. Okay, so that's all I plan to explain in this video. So thank you for watching my video. Make sure to like, comment, share, and make sure to subscribe. Okay, and don't forget to click on that bell button also, so that I can provide you the latest video quickly. And one more thing, please do visit my website, which is www.iammrhelper.com. Link is in the description box below. All the social website links are in the description box below, so always check the description. So until then, take care, have a nice day, and I will see you next time. Bye.